All right, to time your engine, torque down your pulleys. Hopefully you're using all new pulleys, new tensioner. May as well throw a new water pump on there. The 14 millimeters are 29 foot-pounds, and the 12 millimeter here is 14. There might be decimals there, right? I don't worry too much about decimals. You won't have your belt guides on. I do. I have this guide on because I forgot to tighten this oil line down, and the bolt here, there's a bolt here and a bolt here. You can't install this line with the rear timing cover on, so I had to take this cam off. So I figured I'd make this video on timing. Right now, these double lines are not lined up. These are kind of loaded. I'll show you how to set those with 10 millimeter hex sockets. These are, the passenger cams are freely, you can rotate them. So line up your double marks here. I have the timing belt guards torqued down over here from where I had it set before. I'm hoping it's still the same. If it's not, no big deal. But because these cam pulleys don't have a lip like this one does, I can slip the timing belt underneath there. Anyway, grab your new timing belt. You obviously have your crank lined up. So everything's lined up except the driver cams right now. Get the new timing belt on the crank. I'm just gonna loosely hang this on the driver intake. Rotate the passenger intake cam forward a little bit, clockwise a little bit. And watch your crank lines. That likes to pop off. Rotate the passenger exhaust forward a little bit. Get that lined up. Now get two breaker bars, or if you're fancy and you have cam gear tools, use those. I think you'd need a second person with those because they don't stay on. So again, this is just loose. I don't want to change the crank. Rotate your intake. I don't know if you can see it. I'm lined up right there. The single line is lined up with my timing belt line. Rotate that about down where the double line is at 6 o'clock. I'm gonna use my heavier breaker bar. You may have seen that just slipped. I'm kind of keeping pressure on there too. And rotate your exhaust, kind of over-rotate the double line a little bit so you can get your single line lined up with your timing belt. Like that. Push that all the way on. I'm not going to push that all the way on. I think it might have flipped. Nope, we're good. Take that off all the way. So right now the weight of the breaker bars is what's holding the driver cams. Push your belt on the water pump and the splined pulley there. All right, so we don't have this pulley on there yet. Double check your lines. Crank. Passenger intake, single line, single line, single line. single line, I'm all lined up. Here's the tough part. Grab your last pulley. 14 millimeter. You're gonna have to push hard. I've got a socket on the bolt already. I've got Threadlocker on there. I put Threadlock on every bolt that's inside the timing cover. Push hard. I'm even gonna need my socket wrench. I'm gonna use that for torque. Pushing up as hard as I can. I'm pushing. You got, I don't know, 8 threads probably. Now I'm almost there. Double check your lines again. Lined up, lined up, lined up, lined up, lined up. Torque that down to 29 foot-pounds. Remove the breaker bars and Allen bolts, Allen sockets. Pull your tensioner pin. And then install your cover on your intake cam pulley. Actually, I'm going to put some Threadlock on here. I don't believe these are Threadlocked from the factory, but these are tiny bolts. 8 millimeter. Very easy to over torque. So I'll be less tempted to over torque if I've got Threadlocker on there. Inspect that O-ring in there. No better time to replace it than now. If you're doing timing, you might, I mean, definitely check if your cam seals are leaking too. I've got another video on that, installing those, and a video on removing the cam gears. These are 8 millimeters. The guides, Allen sockets, or Allen size is 5 millimeters. I mean, you could easily strip these little bolts. If you wanted at this point, you could rotate via the crank bolt the engine over and over and over and over and over and wait until your markings, it'll take forever for the markings to line up exactly again, but often there'll be 2 teeth off, like this marking on the cam pulley, and the marking on the timing belt might be like two or three teeth off, something low where you could easily count, you know, if that marking's three teeth forward here, 3 teeth forward here, 3 on all 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 points, then you know your timing's on, if you're really paranoid and worried about it. All right, we're all set there. Let's do the guides. Again, these are 5mm hex. To check the clearance here, use the box. Hopefully you got a new thermostat. Use a piece of the box that your thermostat came in, or like your water pump maybe. This is an oil filter piece of cardboard. Place it in there with the guide. Put a little light pressure down. And you get it pretty snug. I've heard of some people doubling this cardboard. I use single and I make sure it can easily slide through like this. Tighten that down. If you get stuck in there, it's like a feeler gauge. Cheap cardboard feeler gauge. If you get stuck in there, you gotta adjust it. I'm happy with that. Then do your crank pulley. And you'll end up doing these two as well. I'll double check those. I'm putting thread locker on the crank pulley bolts. These are 10 mils. Put your cardboard in there. I don't like that. It's hard for me to run that through there. So I'm gonna back off a little bit. Okay, that's better. I'm holding it and pushing towards the back of the engine. That's better. Grab your center outer timing cover and inspect your rubber gaskets here. Ideally, once you started this project. Then there's 7 10mm bolts for this one. There might actually be 8. I've got, mine's broken right here. I think there's 7 of this style. That spacer section, and then I think there's a regular 10 right there where mine's broken. My timing cover is broken on the back side. It's the inner been broken for a long time. Some guys, I haven't really seen it with Subarus, but some guys with other platforms don't even run timing covers, so I'm not worried about it. Once I have all these torqued down, the timing covers don't move. This part's all self-explanatory. Head covers on. Driver's side has 4 bolts, passenger 3. Pretty sure I've got a broken backside right there too, yeah. Moves a bit. But I've ran it that way for a long time. I first noticed it when the car had 105,000 miles when you're supposed to do your timing belt. Car has 162 or 3,000 miles now. This whole project started with an internal head gasket leak, not anything to do with timing, so I'm not worried about it. It's been in, gravel roads, dirt roads, over a dozen track events. Not worried about that. I feel like it's moving more than it used to, but the inner here, the center, is not moving at all, despite this one being missing. All right, I ran those down with the electric wrench. Now I'm going to do a final check by hand. All set. We've got a little bit more to do, and then, well, I'm as you can see, I have the load leveler on there. I'm gonna put it on my hoist. I'm gonna bolt up the turbo. Obviously, I've got the engine harness on there. It's pretty close to ready to drop in. I wanted to drop it in today. We got 16 or 17 inches of snow between Friday and Saturday. Real dense snow, and the STI is stored in my trailer, and the storage owner didn't plow, so I have no chance of getting the STI out of there. I'm getting tuned April 22nd, so I've got plenty of time. All right, good luck.